Hello, and welcome to Maths with Jay. In this video, we'll look at how to input simple calculations and how to edit them. We may need to edit the calculations because we've made errors, or it may just be that we want to do several similar calculations. So this calculator is really good at allowing us to do that. So let's start off by inputting this calculation. Right, here I've made an error. I should have put a zero in before the two. So all I'm going to do is use the del key, del for delete, to delete the two, and then just continue the calculation, continue inputting the calculation. And now I've missed out the 0.4. What I'm going to do this time, just to show you another way of editing, is I'm going to use the left arrow key to reposition the cursor so I can key in the 0.4, and then I'm going to use the right arrow key to get me past the multiplication symbol. Of course, I could have just deleted the multiply, but I wanted to show you how you can use the cursor keys, the right and left arrow keys, to do some editing. So then let's just finish the calculation, and we get the answer by keying in equals. Now, if I wanted to do a similar calculation, I could easily edit the one we've just done. And all I need to do is use the left arrow key. That will leave the cursor at the right end of the calculation, and I can very easily change the last number into a 3. Just use a delete key to delete the 2. Key in a 3 and then press equals. And now I've got a couple of calculations. You can see the up and down arrow appearing at the top of the screen. So I can look back at the first calculation and then go back down to the second calculation. Now let's have a look at editing our second calculation at the left-hand end of the line. So now I'm going to use the right arrow key. So that will leave the cursor at the left end of the calculation, and I'll use the cursor key to the right to get to where I want to edit out the decimal point, use the delete key, and then notice I can do equals from the middle of the calculation, and that gives me the answer to the whole calculation. And if I now want to key in a completely new calculation, I don't need to clear anything, I can just key in 3 plus 4 and get the answer. I could clear a line if I wanted to by using the AC key, but notice I've still got the arrow key at the top of the screen indicating I've still got some history in the calculator, so let's have a look at what's there. You can keep going up looking at all the previous calculations that are in the memory. And back down again if you want. So it can be useful to leave calculations on the calculator. If, however, you just want to get rid of the whole of the history, just use the on key, and then you will have no history of what you've been doing. So do use that one with care. Only use it if you know you've finished with the previous calculations. Now let's have a look at what happens if we input something that the calculator just doesn't recognize. So here, I've input something that is pretty meaningless just to see what happens. So we'll do equals and we get a syntax error. Now we're given the choice of either cancelling the calculation, or if we use either the right or left arrow key, we'll be taken to where the error actually is. So let's do that. And in this case, I don't want the divide. So let's delete that. And then we could go on with the calculation without any problem. So in this video, we've looked at how useful the arrow keys are to edit calculations we've already done or a calculation that we're working on. And then we've looked at the delete key, the AC key, and the on key.